Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2017 action thriller film called The Foreigner. Spoilers ahead. Seat back, relax and enjoy the video. The film opens with a young woman walking to her father's car. The father, Kwan, drives his daughter to a clothing store in Knightsbridge, London, to pick up a dress. The daughter insists on going ahead so that she can get the dress immediately while her father parks the car, and Kwan reluctantly agrees. While Kwan parks, a large explosion occurred, immediately injuring anyone in the vicinity, including Kwan. When Kwan returns to his senses, he realizes that the explosion came from the clothing store. The film then jumps into an office. An employee receives a call about a certain authentic IRA group, telling the employee that they were responsible for the recent bombings. After receiving the information, the employee immediately gives it to his boss, and the boss announces to the rest of the staff to research the situation. Afterward, a photographer takes a shot of every wounded person in the bombing aftermath, except for the scene of Kwan clutching his dead daughter in his arms. In the next scene, we can see the terrorists watching the report of the bombing on their television. A man enters the scene, asking the rest of the group about the number of persons that he got. One of their members tells them that they should move, but one refuses because moving might jeopardize their already hidden identities. The following day, a man named Liam wakes up beside his mistress in Belfast, Ireland. He gets shocked when he sees the messages on his phone about the recent IRA bombing. Worse, he also receives a call from his wife. When Liam answers, his wife immediately asks him where he was, and Liam lies about being in a meeting. In the next scene, Kwan is in his daughter's untouched room. He walks around the room with an obvious emptiness in his heart, looking around at the lively things that once were used by his now deceased daughter. Meanwhile, Liam immediately heads to a meeting. While walking there, a woman calls him about the situation, and Liam replies that a possible solution for this is to release political prisoners that are members of the IRA. When the call ended, Liam immediately confronts the members of the board, telling them that the explosion is not their fault at all, and that a rouge group who calls themselves Authentic IRA has been operating behind their backs. It is revealed then that Liam and the other people there are actually the IRA group. Liam concludes the meeting by saying that he wants every item to be checked so that the bombers can be traced. Afterward, the counter-terrorist force SO-15 is already tracking the bomber. They quickly take the plate number of the motorists. However, they receive a call regarding the return of a Chinese man in the building. It is Kwan. He has been returning daily since his daughter's death. Because of this, the chief, Commander Bromley, personally talks to Kwan about the situation. Kwan initially offers him a hefty sum of money for the name of someone in the IRA, but Bromley refuses this. Kwan then leaves, thanking the commander for the talk. In the next scene, we can see Kwan watching Liam's interview about his denunciation of the IRA's involvement. While watching, a lady who is Kwan's employee in his store enters the room. After seeing the dismal state of Kwan in his room, she decides to open the window blinds, telling Kwan that he should eat. After his interview, Liam's secretary informs him about his other future interviews. She also informs him about a certain Asian man that wants to talk to him. Having no other choice, Liam takes the call. Kwan quickly asks him who killed his daughter. This slightly insulted Liam, but Kwan asks this because he is the deputy minister of the IRA. Liam then tells him that even if he has power, he does not know who did it. Because of this, Kwan becomes more intent on knowing his daughter's killers. As a symbol of not going back, Kwan burns anything related to his past, his family's picture, and the news about his other daughter's abduction. The lady of the house sees this terrifying display from Kwan, deciding that she will take care of him from now on. But when she turns her back on him, Kwan is already gone like the wind. Kwan immediately buys objects that he will later use for his search. He then disguises his van as a gardening tools van. The lady, after finding Kwan, confronts him again, asking him if he will come back. But Kwan silently leaves her. Soon after, Kwan heads straight to Liam's office to personally talk to him. At first, Liam's guards restrain him, but Liam tells them to let him go. Kwan and Liam then talk privately, with Kwan asking once again about the names. Predictably, Liam answers that he still does not know, which made Kwan leave unsatisfied. Before he leaves the building, Kwan makes a makeshift bomb from common items in the bathroom. After he leaves the place, the bomb explodes, and although it never harmed anyone, it sure did affect everyone in the building. Immediately, an investigation is conducted. Liam and company then receive a call from Kwan, who asks again about the names. At this point, Liam is furious about the bombing. Kwan hangs up on him, prompting Liam to call his ranger nephew who is currently in New York. Afterward, Quan rents a nearby apartment room where he quickly creates another devilish concoction. In the next scene, two of Liam's men are about to leave the parking lot when one of them notices that the car is wired with an explosive. Because of this, they track Quan's location, and they immediately spot him in his apartment. Liam's men quickly get there to arrest Quan, but Quan expertly and creatively fights them off. After this mess, Liam furiously berates his men about their failure to capture one elderly Asian man. When his wife enters the scene, Liam tells her immediately to pack her things because they are going to their farm. Afterward, Liam's nephew arrives at the house fresh from New York. Liam then tells his nephew to go to Bromley and tell him about what they are doing about the situation. He wants it to be a secret because other IRA members might know about it. In the next scene, Liam arrives at a restaurant, with Quan already waiting there for him in his van. Liam then enters the restaurant, immediately kissing his mistress that is waiting for him there. Because of this, Quan takes a picture of their affectionate kiss and sends it to Liam, intending to scare him. Meanwhile, Liam's nephew arrives at his meeting place with Bromley. Bromley does not trust the IRA, but the nephew informs him that they are conducting a secret plan to catch the bombers. This will be done by secretly giving each group a specific code word. Bromley agreed to cooperate. However, he wants to talk to Liam directly when that time comes. Afterward, Liam arrives on his farm. While this is happening, Quan is already settling himself in the forest nearby. That night, Quan easily infiltrated the farm, successfully planting a bomb while also suppressing two of Liam's men. After the bomb explodes, Liam comments that he needs more men because he underestimated Quan again. Afterward, Liam goes to his room. His wife tells him that she is going to her daughter's flat in London. In the next scene, the terrorists are planning to bomb a plane with no Irish in it. Meanwhile, a woman, who is also Liam's mistress, seduces a man with a laptop inside a pub. The following day, another incident occurred near the farm. A car belonging to one of Liam's men has turned to its side by an explosion. Because of this, the men immediately head to where they think Quan is hiding, the forest. After arriving there, the men encounter many of Quan's ingenious traps. Because of this, Quan easily defeats them, but one of Liam's men manages to wound him in the shoulder, making him retreat for now. Liam's man then informs Liam that he needs to bring a tracker with him, which means Liam's nephew is needed for the job. The film then jumps to London, where Liam's wife is applying her makeup on her face. She then receives a knock on the door. It is Liam's nephew. The wife asks her a couple of things, but she is clearly seducing her. The nephew finally gives in to the temptation. It turns out that they are secretly having an affair. However, this gets momentarily stopped when Liam calls his nephew, informing him that he needs him on the farm tomorrow. The nephew accepts. After the call, Liam's wife pours out her emotions about Liam, telling her nephew that she is angry at Liam for her brother's death. In the next scene, we return to a reminiscing Quan. As he burns his wound to heal it, Quan remembers how his daughters were abducted by pirates, and how he and his wife were shot off the boat. Meanwhile, Liam receives information about Quan. He finally learns about his past, that he was once a US soldier who served in Vietnam, and that he is dangerous because he is highly skilled. However, this is abruptly cut when one of Liam's fellow members enters the room to talk to him. They get to an argument about how soft Liam had become, a far cry from his revolutionary past. Liam furiously replies that he is now doing what he can for peace, making his friend leave in disappointment. After he leaves, Liam calls his dog, but the dog is not responding. After noticing that his gun is missing as well, Quan emerges from a room, pointing a gun at Liam. After telling Liam that the dog is just asleep, he asks again about his daughter's killers. When Liam predictably answers that he does not know, Quan threatens him, forcing Liam to reveal his secret plan about the code words. Because of this, Quan lets him off so that he can catch the bombers, but only for 24 hours. The following day, Liam's mistress walks out of a two-decker bus. The bus then explodes in the middle of a bridge, killing 16 dead. Because of this, Bromley immediately calls Liam about the event, telling him that the bombers never used a code word at all. Liam then tells him that he will see what he can do. After answering another call, Liam is then informed by one of his men that his wife was visited by his nephew in London, that after 2 hours of closed-door activities, his wife then talks to Liam's friend. Meanwhile, Liam's nephew, newly arrived from London, immediately heads to the nearby forest to neutralize Quan. In the next scene, the terrorists are talking about how they managed to create a bomb disguised as a laptop battery. While this is happening, the SO-15 manages to track one of the terrorists by his burn mark, and that they also have footage of him talking to an IRA member. Because of this, Bromley immediately calls Liam to inform him that the turncoat is his own friend. He also informs Liam that they can see him via drone, and that if he does nothing about his friend, they will arrest him with the full force of the law. Already furious about the betrayal, Liam promptly interrogates his friend about the bomber's names. Initially failing to cooperate, he shoots him in the leg. After his friend gives him the information he needs, including his wife's talk with him, Liam ends his friend's life. Meanwhile, Liam's mistress has just finished making love with the man she seduced in the pub. After the man cleans himself in the bathroom, the mistress swiftly changes the laptop's battery with the bomb, making the man an unwitting bomb carrier. In the next scene, Liam's nephew tracks Quan in the forest. After fighting each other, Quan emerges victorious. Liam's nephew then wakes up to find himself tied to a tree, where Quan interrogates him about the killer's names. Liam's nephew already receives the information from his uncle, and so, he gives it freely to Quan. Because of this, Quan lets him go. The nephew immediately returns to his uncle to inform him that Quan spared him. However, this is the least of Liam's concerns. Liam then tells his nephew that he already knows about him and his wife's affair. He also informs his nephew that his wife is the one that gave the bombers information about the use of code words. Because of this, he orders his nephew to return to New York, as well as one final task. Back in London, SO15 circles around the building where the terrorists reside. But before they can do anything, Quan manages to infiltrate the room while he is disguised as a mechanic. After the bombers discover his rifle, a fight breaks out between them. Quan manages to kill all of them by himself, except for the mistress. Quan then escapes. The counter-terrorists enter the room to find the room ransacked. They then forcefully extract information from the surviving mistress about the bomb. Because of this, they immediately inform the airport about the bomb. Luckily, they manage to throw the bomb away, averting multiple deaths in the process. Meanwhile, Quan is now a wanted man. In the next scene, Liam receives a phone call, informing him that while he helped stop the terrorists, he is now in full service of the British government. Meanwhile, Liam's wife gets shot by her nephew and lover. As he arrives at his hotel, Liam is confronted by Quan, who forces Liam to post the picture of him kissing his mistress. Because of this, Liam's career is sure to fall. Quan then returns to his store. Bromley is informed about his return, but Bromley tells his men that they should not arrest him as gratitude for his help. The film ends with the lady happily kissing Quan for his return. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.